Hey everyone, we are asked to provide the electron configuration of cobalt in the standard and noble gas notation. I recommend that you take a minute now and try to solve this problem on your own before we go through the answer together. When finding the electron configuration of an atom, we are being asked where does this atom place its electrons, i.e. what shells and orbitals are its electrons most likely to be found in. So, to solve this, the first thing that we need to do is look at our periodic table and see how many electrons a cobalt atom actually has in its ground or unexcited state. Looking this up, we can see that cobalt is number 27 on the periodic table, meaning that in a neutral state, no positive or negative charge, our cobalt atom will have 27 protons in its nucleus and thus 27 electrons surrounding that nucleus. Let's also remember that in past videos, we talked about this handy device for remembering which orbitals have the lowest energy, as those are the orbitals that are going to get filled first. So, since we have 27 electrons to place, let's use this Bohr model of cobalt to help us keep track of all of our electrons. Recall that with this Bohr model, each of these rings around our cobalt center denotes an energy level on our energy level diagram. So each row here is associated with a ring on our Bohr model. The further we move away from our center, the higher energy level we are at. Now, let's work out the electron configuration of cobalt. As always, we'll begin with the 1s subshell. And as we discussed before, the 1s subshell can hold 2 electrons. So that leaves us with 25 electrons left. Next, following our energy level arrows, we have the 2s subshell, which again can take 2 electrons. Then we are going to move to the 2p orbitals, of which there are 3, and these orbitals can all take 2 electrons. In total, we can place 6 electrons in our 3 2p orbitals. This leaves us with 19 electrons left to place. Again, following our energy level diagram, we see that we have the 3s subshell next. And because this is an s subshell, it can take 2 electrons, leaving us with 17 electrons. We then have another p orbital, which can again take 6 electrons. Next is our 4s orbital, which can take 2 electrons. Now we have our first d orbital, which can actually hold 10 electrons. And we have 7 electrons left to place. Recall that we place 1 electron in its own orbital before pairing them up. Therefore, we will get an electron configuration that looks like this. We can now write out our standard notation like so. This is just a more concise way of writing our above electron energy diagram. To write the noble gas notation, we simply look at the noble gas that has a lower atomic number than cobalt. So that is going to be argon. In the noble gas notation, we simply shorten this section of argon's ground state electron configuration and then write out the remaining electrons like so. We have now solved for the ground state electron configuration of cobalt in the standard and noble gas notations. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how we find cobalt's electron configuration. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.